hot button topic of divorce finally comes up. Matthew 19:3. The Pharisees also came to him, tempting him. Mark 10:2. And the Pharisees came to him and asked him. I could have and the Pharisees also. Yeah, I could do that. So the and would be Mark only. The Pharisees is both. Also is Matthew only. Came to him is both. Matthew says, tempting him and saying to him, is it lawful? Mark has and asked him, is it lawful? So, asked him, or tempting him, saying to him. Definitely going to put tempting him, but then I have a choice between asked or saying. Tempted him, asked, or tempted him, saying. I think asked is better because it is a question. So I'll put the word ask. But still, tempting him is first, and that's only Matthew. And is both. Asked is Mark only. Him is both. Is it lawful for a man to put away his wife? That's both. What they're asking here, it's better explained here in Matthew. Is it lawful for a man to put away his wife for every cause? Meaning, whatever reason you want. And that also is because of what it says in Deuteronomy 24. Verse 1, when a man has taken a wife and married her, and it come to pass that she finds no favor in his eyes, because he has found some uncleanness in her. So you could take that first part, she finds no favor in his eyes. How could you displease someone? There's infinite ways you can displease someone. So I think that's why they're asking the question. To put away a wife for every cause that the man could possibly come up with. And apparently there were dissenting parties on this issue, where some said yes for every cause, but others said no, it has to be for fornication or something like that. But I'm definitely going to include this added statement. That really clears it up. His is in italics in Mark. But it's actually there in Matthew, so I'll say it's only Matthew. His wife is both. And then there's just the question mark in... Oh, look, it does say tempting him in Mark. I think I'm going to keep it in the order of Matthew. They came to him tempting him and asked, because that way, right from the beginning, you know it's a test. There's ulterior motives. So tempting him, I'll put that as both. But after wife, it's just a question mark in Mark. Matthew has for every cause. Now the question mark is both. Matthew, and he answered and said to them. Mark, and he answered and said to them. So that's both. Mark has, what did Moses command you? Matthew has, have you not read that he which made them at the beginning made them male and female? So that statement is in Mark, but it's later. Verse 6, but from the beginning of the creation God made them male and female. In Matthew, he doesn't initiate the question of Moses. He does in Mark, however. In Mark, he just goes right into saying, what did Moses command you? They said Moses suffered or permitted to write a bill of divorcement to put her away. So in Mark, it just goes right to the law. Jesus points to the law that Moses gave. They know what the law is. And Jesus answered, for the hardness of your heart. That's the reason. But in Matthew, he goes not just to the law, but even the more foundational, even before the law, having not read that he which made them at the beginning made them male and female, and said, for this cause shall a man leave father and mother and shall cling to his wife, and they two shall become one flesh, wherefore they are no more two, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder. And then they bring up, why then did Moses command to give a writing of divorcement? So they ask, why then? So that's like a retort to Jesus' answer. But in Mark, it's just a response to Jesus' question. And they said, well, the answer is that Moses allowed or suffered to write a bill of divorce. Where is it in Luke again? Oh yeah, it's just whosoever puts away his wife and marries another commits adultery. I gotta add that in here. So that's verse 9 in Matthew 19. So that's way later. And in Mark, whosoever puts away his wife, verse 11. So it is way later. I gotta solve this now then, without looking at Luke. Who brings up Moses? Well, I could just put how Mark has it, because it says that's what Jesus said. In Matthew, he begins with the creation. He does speak of the creation in Mark, but it's shorter. I guess I could just extend it. You know, it makes more sense that Jesus would go right to the law, because he already knows that they are going to, that they already have that in mind. He knows that they want to talk about the law. So for Jesus just to go right to and say, what did Moses say? I already know you want to talk about that, so I'll just bait you. And they say, well, we can write a bill of divorce. And then he gives the more important answer, that was for the hardness of their heart, but it was not supposed to be that way. That's not ideal. And then I could put, for this cause shall a man leave his father. Or I could say, but have you not read from Matthew, from the beginning, or that he which made them at the beginning made them male and female. Yeah, that's what I'll do. So I'll have it the way Mark has it. So they're tempting him with the question. And then it begins with Jesus' response about Moses. And he answered and said to them, now Mark only, what did Moses command you? And they go back about Moses. So I would have to change their response in Matthew from why did Moses then command to give a writing of divorce and to put her away to the way Mark has it, just as a statement. Moses suffered or permitted to write a bill of divorcement and to put her away. Because that's their response to the question. But I will still combine as many of those words as I can. So, and they said, they say to him. So, and is still Mark. And they is both. I think I'd rather keep it as past tense. So, said is Mark only. Now, Matthew to him. Matthew, why did Moses then? But I know I'm not going to do that. The response is just Moses. Suffered. And that's a better word because it does mean permit. Take the hardship and let the thing come to pass. Suffer it to happen. It's not really suffering. It's mental, I guess, but that's what it means. And I will underline it to have the note, which is here, permitted. Moses suffered, but that's not both. That's only Mark. To write a bill of divorcement. Matthew has commanded to give a writing of divorcement. To write a bill of divorcement or to give a writing? I think the give is another important part because you can write it. I'm really splitting hairs here, but I'm just trying to look at this from a legal standpoint. If you do write the bill of divorcement and put her away, that doesn't necessarily mean that she ended up with that bill of divorcement. This is the whole issue. Does she have the paperwork to prove it? So I'm definitely going to keep the word give in here. To say that she must end up with that paperwork. Two is both. Matthew only now. Give a writing. Give a writing of divorcement is both. Oh, wait. A bill of divorcement. Maybe I could say to give a writing of a bill of divorcement. Maybe I could say from Mark to write. And then add from Matthew, and give a bill of divorcement. Is there an and in here? And to put her away. Yeah, both have and to put her away. So I could do that. Suffered to write and give her a bill of divorcement. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. Of divorcement is both. And to put her away. The her is in italics in Mark, but it's actually there in Matthew.